Realization of a 8:1 mux using 8-bit resistor in Verilog. In this video, we'll understand how to code for 8:1 mux and use 8-bit resistor within Verilog, and how can we also use its individual bits so that to realize this 8:1 mux. So let's get started. Hi, my name is Amit and welcome to my channel. Let us take an example of a router, wherein you have one input to it from the network provider and you have multiple devices connected to that router. So it has got one output, probably one input as well. So mux and demux, we can say. So mux can practically be used in this routers, in switches. Or let's take an example of a fiber optic communication where you are going to transmit multiple data from multiple sources through one line. Right, so you have to select which input to be passed now for this particular instance. So that's what it happens within mux, and let's understand with this diagram and how does this functions, and later on we'll understand how to code it. So here in this diagram you could see that it has got input. So I could call this as an input one, okay, input one, and this as my input seven, input eight. Okay, input 8. So this 0, 1, 2, 3, 8 inputs. So now which output, which input is going to get at the output is going to get decided with this switch. But the switch has got a control. Okay, so there are, let's say for example, 8 switches here. And which switch to now, which switch is going to get close need to be decided, and that is going to get decided with a select line. Okay, these are nothing but select line. So this select line decides which switch is going to turn on, so that which input is going to get to the output, right? So this select line, here we are using 3 select lines. That means 2^3 is equals to 8. So that means 8 inputs can be controlled with 3 select lines. So this is what is about the mux. So this is the 1-bit input that I am talking about. This is 1-bit, okay, this is 1-bit input, and there could be also an analog switches, okay, like for example in this diagram you could see this is also an mux. So in this mux you could see that this switch is closed. Now this, if this switch is closed, so here a particular one number, let's say this is 1, 2, 3, and 4, so first number switch is selected. So that means this first input is going to get select, is going to pass to the output, okay, and that is going to get decided with this select lines. So in here we call this as A0 to A1. Now since there are 4 inputs, so we have got 2^2 is equals to 4, right? So we need only 2 select lines to have 4 inputs. So that is what. So we have got digital switches as well and the analog switches as well. So in here we are going to talk about digital switch, and we are going to code for digital switch. So let's get started with the code. So here I have already created a project. If you want to get into details of project creation, I'll give the link in the description box to understand how to create a project. Here I am gonna use the created project, and let's code it accordingly. So first of all, I need an output, right? So I'm gonna need a line which will give me as an output, and it will be of single bit. So I also need an input. I call this as an in, and also got to have a select line. So this is what is select line. Now this select line and input are my inputs, okay, and out is my output of this system. So let's decide what is what. So output is equals to out, and in is my input, right? But it is a 8-bit resistor, so let's declare it as 8-bit resistor. So 7:0, so this is how it is an 8-bit resistor. Now we are going to use this 8-bit input resistor to have our output, right? And also I need a select line, so select line is also an 4-bit resistor, Okay, and let's call this as a select line. And when am I going to give the output? That's what we need to decide. So always at the rate, and whenever if there is any change in input or there is change in select line, I need to get output. Okay, so in this case, let's begin the loop end. Okay, and in this case I'm going to use a switch, switch case. So case where I'm going to give this as select, and my case is I'm going to put this in 3 bits. So initially this would be my case, right? And we cannot give directly output to an wire, because this output is going to be a wire, and we cannot give output to a wire in here. So let's create a resistor variable. Resistor, let's call this as output temporary, and output temporary, it is equal to 0 initially. Okay, and what we are going to do is we are going to use this command assign out equal to out t. Okay, so let's take this, and here I also going to get in this case. So here I'm going to use this as input, and I'm expecting it will, means I'll only pass 1 bit at a time. Okay, so this is nothing but the 0th bit of an input. This is the first bit of an input. Let's code it accordingly. This is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so we are using 3B. We need to have this 3B. Here we have the semicolon missing. Okay, so now we need to provide the input as well. One, this is 1, 1, 1, 1. This is my 4, and this is 5. This is 6, and this is 7. Right? So we have got select line. If this is 00, select 00, my output is nothing but from bit 0. Okay, and depending on the select line, I'm going to get this output from either of the bit. Okay, from the 8-bit. So this is how we can code 8-bit registers for an individual bit. This is how we can use 8-bit registers with an individual bit, right? So let's compile this and let's understand if we have any doubt. Okay, so our compilation is successful, right? It has got synthesized. So we are good to start with the simulation, and in simulation we are going to create a test bench, and within test bench we'll give input to this input and select lines, and we'll understand how is it performing, whether I'm getting respective inputs, respective outputs or not, right? So let's click on this simulation, and in simulation let's create a new project, new source, and it has to be Verilog test fixture. So let's call this as test mux, which is 8:1. Okay, 8:1 mux, and which module, okay, replace it, and which unit under test it want is this one which we have already created, right? So it is going to take that, associate it, and it is going to create us a simulation test bench. Okay, this is going to my test bench. So let's close view of this settings. Okay, so we have got this as wire, output as wire, and it has got it has instantiated my design. Okay, with this UUT. Okay, and here we can give our inputs. So as I was talking about, we can also tweak this timescale resistors. In one of our video, one of my viewer asked that he is not able to change this to some different value other than this. So it is because actually this timescale resistors, this time precision and timescale has got predefined values, default values, and those default values, like for example timescale, this is 1 nanosecond by 1 picosecond, and for precision it is 1 picoseconds. So it is in the multiples of, you can change this in multiples of 10, like for example if I want to make this as 20, if I want to make this as 50, and if I wanted to make this as 20, it is doable, it works. Like, let's test this out with this twist. Let's get on here and let's simulate our design. Right, so you could see that it compiled successfully. So that means we could change the timescale value in multiples of 10. But if you wanted to change this in multiples of 1 or 2, it is not possible because the default value is set accordingly. So if you want to change this values to default values to some different values, so we have got this TCL commands, so you can go through that. But here we are going to stick with the default values, like for example 1 nanosecond by 1 picosecond. So let's get further testing the simulation test bench. So here is my test bench, and within test bench I'm able to give the inputs. So my input to over here is let's say 1, because I want my 0th bit to be 1 at initially, and then after I'm going to change its value to whatever I want, right? So let's keep this delay as 100. Okay, 100 positive ticks. Okay, and I'm going to change now this to within 2. If I need to understand this, because if I make this 1, so that means my 1 bit of this, if I write this in binary, let's for example let's do it in write in binary, 8 tick b 0000. So as we have given 1, which means in binary it is going to become like this. So this is my 0th bit, and if I write something over here, now that is going to get reflected over here. So if I write here 2, so it is going to be 1 at this position, and since I'm selecting 1, okay, so it is going to get into this case, and it is going to pick up the second bit of a input, right? So and if it is 1 again, so I'm going to get straight line at the output, so I don't want that to happen. So I'll make this as I'll keep this as 1 itself, okay? And then here, now what I'm going to do is I want my third bit to be 1, and rest of the other should be 0. So which means at the output I'll get 1. So what is going to happen, this will be 1. So at the output, what we'll expect is output is going to be 1 here, and output out is going to be 0 over here, and output is going to be 1 again here. So what we are trying to make out is we are trying to generate a square wave at the output. Okay, so that's what we are interested in. So that's what we are doing, and giving our values accordingly. So to understand, am I getting value from the respective bit of a resistor or not? Okay, so that's what we are trying to make out here. So fourth, then if I want to make this as fifth bit, so I'll keep this as 4. Okay, I'll keep this as 4, and this will be 3. and I'm going to code this accordingly. Let me delete this for better view. So here it will be 4 and this is going to be 8. So I'm expecting here it to be 0, here it to be 1. Okay, I purposefully copied few of the lines. This is 4, this is going to be 5, 6, and 7. So here it will be, now I need to give it in hex. Okay, if you don't give anything here, which means it is in decimal, and if you specify in what format you are going to give, it will take it the specific format. Now since we want the upper 4 bits to be 1, so I'm going to make this as 1 and this is going to be 0. Okay, so this is the easiest way to do so. Here I want it to be 0, right? So let's make this as 0. No, if I want here it to be 1, so it has to be 8. It is 8, and 8 will remain over here. I want here it to be 0, so I can keep this as 8 itself. Let's understand what has happened. Yes, so within here we could see that it has generated me an output until this selection is 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, and then onwards we have not got the output, right? So we need to check what happened over there, and let's debug this. Okay, so here was the error that at fourth selection point your fifth bit of an register is going to get selected. So we need to adjust with the data so that we can have one at that particular location. So earlier it wasn't happening with that, and we missed with the output. So we need to have a concentration that what values we are expecting and whether we are going to get that value or not, and what mistakes have we done in the code. So that's what we have rectified, that at the fifth position there has to be 1, okay, when it will be a selection point 1. So that's what is happening over here. Now I could see that at selection point 00 my this bit is high. So that is how we have got the nice wave in the output signal. So that is what we were expecting, that at particular instance it should pick up the respective bit of the register. That is, it has picked up the 0th bit here, and here it has picked the second bit, first bit. I mean, like if you start with 0, so this is 0, this is 1. Here it picked up the third bit, and here it picked the 4th, 5th, 6th, and so on. So this is how we can use 8-bit registers to design a 8:1 MUX. If you're a fresher and want to accelerate your learning and career growth, let's meet live. Register for my masterclass with the link amit.ninja/live. Link is in the description box as well. If you want to understand timescale in detail, here is the link for you. And if you want to understand the step-by-step process of creating new project in Xilinx ISE, here is the link for you. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. That is it for now. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.